1985 marked a fun-filled year with Lethbridge citizens, young and old, celebrating the city's 100th anniversary. Let's go back to when it began with the opening ceremonies. There were over 250 participants, plus the same number in support staff involved in this ceremony, which encompassed the breadth of our varied ethnic community. Over 5,500 citizens were thrilled by the performance, which proved to be an excellent springboard for the remainder of the year, as well as a tough act to follow. The main theme included the past, present, and future as entertaining, historical, and community-oriented. In total, there were approximately 6,500 man-hours required to put together this unforgettable performance. With the opening of the centennial completed, evidence of Lethbridge's centennial was popping up everywhere, on trucks, doors, walls, and even on coffee cups. Of over 220 entries to the centennial logo competition, Mr. Ron McFadden's colorful and eye-catching design was the winner. The full-color centennial logo selected depicts our blue skies, mountains, and farming landscape, the high-level bridge, university, heritage of coal mining, plus our dedication to family life. Besides the centennial logo, the committee decided to have a centennial song contest. Entries in this contest numbered 18, and the winning entry was composed by Mr. Dennis LeClaire. His song, The Town of Lethbridge, captures in musical lyric our colorful past. Lethbridge did much more than design logos and create a centennial song. We dressed in period costume for the occasion. There were 13 performances of period fashions during the year, with the gowns being original heirlooms donated by local citizens. This proved to be a popular attraction for visiting conventions and added some color throughout the centennial year. This very special year saw the start of the first annual Miss Teen Lethbridge pageant. The citizens of Lethbridge proved that past, present, and future can all be saluted in our progressive community. With the arrival of spring, a spring ball was organized at the exhibition pavilion. This was a family affair which was a happy event for those who attended. The Centennial Committee did not stop after completion of the spring ball. Work continued on the numerous centennial projects. To help the citizens remember their past, an important centennial project was undertaken with the writing of a book on the history of Lethbridge by Alex Johnston and Andy Den Otter. The book took 2 years to complete and was well accepted by Lethbridgians, with pre-publication sales of approximately 400 copies and over 2,600 during the centennial year. This book truly opened the doors to our past. The Sports Hall of Fame, a major centennial legacy, was funded by the Elks Club of Lethbridge. The official opening on April 27th acknowledged 32 individual and 6 team sports greats from our past. A special ceremony to launch the Fort Stamp was held in Lethbridge on July 22nd. The ceremony was organized by the Centennial Committee with the assistance of regional personnel from Canada Post Corporation. Dignitaries from Ottawa, Edmonton, and Canada Post were in attendance. Canada Post folders prepared for the occasion were presented to the special guests. Over 800 attended the celebration and were royally entertained by the 28-member Momenthaler band from West Germany while sharing a giant birthday cake decorated to represent the first day cover of our centennial stamp. The stamp was just one of the many activities during homecoming week. An extensive program was undertaken to get invitations out to all ex-residents of Lethbridge to return for this one-week celebration. This was a very successful undertaking, with approximately 3,800 people returning from points as far away as London, England, Budapest, Tokyo, and Melbourne, Australia. Activities were endless during this week, with activities such as the Lethbridge Trap Club Centennial Shoot, historical walking tours, special tours of Lethbridge Community College and the Lethbridge Research Station, centennial picnics, Little League baseball tournaments, soccer tournaments, senior citizen celebrations, LCI and CCH reunions, teen rock extravaganza, Lethbridge Symphony Baroque concert, seniors slow pitch tournament, Royal Regiment of Wales band concerts, and the crowning of the Pioneer King and Queen. Ernie Reisler and Mary Syme were the Centennial's Pioneer King and Queen. They were crowned at the Momenthaler Brass Band concert. Ernie and Mary reigned over key events for the remainder of Centennial year. Prior to the crowning of the King and Queen, the audience was entertained by the Momenthaler Band brought to Lethbridge by the German Canadian Club. To top off the Centennial homecoming week, the Kinsmen Club organized an old-fashioned picnic complete with old-fashioned prices. The picnic, a tremendous success, was held at Nicholas Sharon Park in West Lethbridge with over 5,000 people in attendance. The historical trail ride from Waterton to Lethbridge arrived in mid-afternoon and added their own entertainment with horse rides for the children, music for all, and then showed the Sasquatch they captured along the trail. The picnic was capped off with a mass band concert. All of the bands gathered in Lethbridge for the Hoop Up Parade. Lethbridge moved from one exciting week into another with the beginning of our annual fair and exhibition known as Hoop Up Days. This year's theme, you guessed it, Lethbridge 100 Years. Hoop Up was kicked off with two huge pancake breakfasts. Lethbridge Center served breakfast to over 8,800 people, and then the 13th Street Businessmen's Association followed up by serving 2,500 people the very next day. This year's Hoop Up Parade was one of the best on record, sparkled like never before. Hoop Up Week ended with a spectacular air show featuring Canada's Snowbirds, sponsored by the Lethbridge Flying Club and the Gyro Club. The combination of the Snowbirds, Skyhawks, and British Army Air Corps set the stage for a show that proved to be a major highlight of the 2 weeks of celebrations, with over 900 in attendance. Color, precision, and pure excitement could not ask for anything better than the RCMP musical ride. And here they are, entertaining over 3,000 people at the grandstand. One of the real highlights of the year was the visit of Their Excellencies Madame and Monsieur Sauvet. A tour past most of the schools in Lethbridge allowed 7,000 students to see the Governor General. An early close of schools allowed everyone to attend a major gathering at the Sportsplex, with an accent on youth as the theme. It was the setting for an emotional and happy meeting of over 3,000 men, women, and children, all happy to express their delight at seeing their Governor General. She started her presentation with the statement that the warmth of this community is such that she could set aside her prepared speech and speak from the heart. The visit of the Governor General was just a sample of the great things to come during Centennial Week, opening with a joyous, fun-filled night at the Mardi Gras party, a Lethbridge Symphony concert with guest artist Maureen Forrester, Centennial tree planting at the high schools, and an old-time barn dance plus Centennial Day celebrations. September 24th, Centennial Day, was marked with events at several locations around the city. They began with a parade involving 48 floats and 800 participants. This was followed by the official opening of the Sir Alexander Galt Museum, now one of the finest in Canada. At 12 noon, bells, whistles, chimes, and horns sounded, climaxed by a 100-gun salute to Lethbridge's Centennial, the salute conducted by the 20th Independent Field Battery, Royal Regiment of Canadian Artillery of Lethbridge. The afternoon continued with the official openings of Indian Battle Park and Fort Hoopa. Centennial celebrations were not forgotten after Centennial Day. An old-fashioned threshing bee was conducted and illustrated how we threshed wheat years and years ago. An historical train, courtesy of CP Rail, made a stop later in the year to help celebrate Lethbridge's birthday. The Time Capsule Project from the University of Lethbridge won international acclaim and features a certificate which will be worth $2 million when the capsule is opened in 2067. Another legacy project funded by the Miners Library is the robot Officer Miner Brown, which will be a tremendous aid to our young people in teaching safety for years to come. As the year was quickly coming to a close, we began looking to our future with the opening of the new wing of Lethbridge Community College. The past, however, was not forgotten with the unveiling of a life-size sculpture of a coal miner by Southern Alberta's Corny Martins. The sculpture is now on permanent display in the new college center. One of the final projects the Centennial would see was that of the Lethbridge Wind Gauge. This was a project undertaken by General Stewart Branch of the Royal Canadian Legion. It is both historic and also offers a light-hearted approach to our famous westerly winds. The Wind Gauge site is also acting as a home to our three time capsules that will be reopened in 2010 AD, 2035 AD, and 2085 AD. Citizens have been given the opportunity to place information, pictures, and memorabilia in envelopes registered for delivery by a future committee. While people organized their contributions to the time capsules, an afternoon of family skating was marking an end of the year-long centennial event. Speeches by dignitaries culminated by the fantastic fireworks display heralded an end to the year-long party, as well as an enthusiastic kickoff for the second century. As citizens look back, the year was filled with band concerts, official openings, dances, community donations, musical rides, picnics, reunions, introduction of the Sports Hall of Fame, Canada Day celebrations, Stern Wheeler trips on the Old Man River, and many, many other activities. As citizens of Lethbridge, we can look back on the centennial year and our past 100 years with joy, but we eagerly await the next 100 years with anticipation.